What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Total War Attila, the Scourge of the North. With me, JERMgaming, and EvilViking13.
What's up, guys?
We have been scourging the North for about the last 10 episodes. Things are actually looking up for us. But yeah. The Huns have now shown up, and that could possibly be an issue. They've always been here, but now they're showing up kind of close to us. They're coming a little bit north into the territory we've been capturing, so we're falling back a little bit. We have four armies in this area. Each of us have two armies. We've got a couple rebel armies we need to take care of first, and one of my armies have lost a lot of guys. But
yeah,
the Huns have fairly advanced-looking units, which is a little bit concerning.
I actually can't see them, so I'll take your word for it.
Well, they look at it. They're units I don't recognize, so some of them are more baseline units, some of them aren't. But we're hoping that if they are serious about starting something, our four armies might be able to beat them back. Maybe.
And let's not forget that last episode you lost your capital, too.
I did. I lost, thank you for bringing up my shame, I lost Hrefnasolt to a rebellion. I just missed it one turn. Everybody was super happy until they weren't. They rose up, overthrew me. So, Dave is going to take that back at some point when he's able, when his tax revenue will allow it. And he's just going to keep that as an extra city. Since I own more cities than he does currently, I'm just going to let him have that and worry about it. And then I'll just consolidate all my cities over in Europe.
What I'm actually doing is I'm sending my small fleet back home. I'll use them to ferry my army from Alibu over to Hrefnasolt, which was Jeremiah's capital, until he lost it. And then those naval units should hopefully be able to join in on the siege. That would definitely help out. A quick save there. Go ahead and get the hard drive spun up. I'm thinking rebel armies first. What do you think, Jeremiah?
Yeah, I mean, I'm not going to be able to get to you to help you with either of them, so...
I should be able to handle it, no problem. I'm going to go ahead and do that, because I'm not going to spend any money until I know where these rebels are. Dead is what I'm hoping. We're retreating backwards.
Yeah, I hate it when they run.
Wait. Oh, nope. Can't reach him. Okay. My army just went, kill the cowards. Oh, awkward. I couldn't quite reach them.
And now you're in friendly territory, like the Saxons like us, I think.
Yeah, I'll apologize. Okay. That does leave Lugdunensis. Undefended, but they're very happy for a settlement that I just captured recently. Pretty surprising.
Lugdunum?
Yeah.
Yeah, they seem like they're doing alright.
Alright, well, in that case, I'll spend my money back home on troops to take your capital, so it does some good at least, right?
Yeah. Thirsty for battle.
You don't sound very enthusiastic about me taking over your capital, Jeremiah.
No, I'm happy about it. I'm not really making a lot of money right now, and I didn't have as much in the bank as I wanted, so I need to kill off some troops by attacking some people, but I can't really do that because I need to save them for the Huns. I'm just kind of in a little bit of a holding pattern right here.
Yeah, and I feel like that $1,000 I was saving up for something important, but I need troops right now, so...
I feel like I've given you a lot of interest-free loans.
Not recently. I've been doing okay. I mean, scraping by at least recently.
Ooh. Uh-oh. What are the Saxons doing? Are they helping? They're helping. They're attacking
the rebels.
They're
helping.
Okay, sweet. We should... We should try to maintain some good relations with them.
Seeing you can't fight this battle, I'm just going to auto-resolve. Odds are like...
I'm sure you're going to massacre them.
Yeah, we're going to auto-resolve. Let's be balanced.
I guess the Saxons are taking that. You're just reinforcing, right?
Yeah. I should be just fine.
All right, sweet. That was actually pretty cool of them to chip in. I know they were in their territory, but still.
I'm going to take on warriors and get that replenishment.
So, the Huns didn't really do... Oh, the Huns are going back down south a little.
That's right, they are.
It's curious, if we, like... How many more Huns are on the map, you know? If we defeated those couple armies, do we win?
I think there's a lot more than we can see. I think we have to go out to like the steppes in the east and like find every single horde that's out there.
I mean, eventually we are going to own this entire map. So yeah. I don't care if this is a 300 episode series, you know what I'm saying? We're going to own this entire map.
It's pretty impressive. You know, Joel's record in Total War wasn't great. We're over a year now and still going, episode 21.
All right. So I'm not having a food shortage. Wait, why am I making so much money now? Hold on.
You lost a bunch of stuff back home. Maybe you actually lost more of like the drains on your
maybe
economy.
But the Children of Doom, oh, they are replenishing now, and the Warrior Scalds are replenishing as well. They're not at full strength, but that's good. I mean, I'm just going to bank money for a few turns then.
Jeremiah, I have a slight request just for your armies.
Oh, okay. I thought you were about to ask me for money again.
No, I'm not. Not this time. The Children of Doom, I'm looking at your stack there. Would you mind just for me renaming that army to the Wheels of Doom? For the catapults?
I can. Where do I rename it?
Go into the army's information panel on the lower left. There's like a little scroll I think you click on. And then in the top box, you can just click on their army name and just backspace. And
oh, sweet. Okay, that's easier than I thought it was going to be.
Yeah. The Wheels of Doom. So many catapults. Oh, man.
I'm going to rename it something slightly different. Given what I use them for, they are now the Wheels of Hellfire.
Also acceptable.
I'm gonna leave them hanging back here where they can replenish, because I don't want to pull them up towards Visantio and like trigger the Huns.
Yeah.
If the Huns keep coming farther, I am rushing up to support you as soon as possible.
Okay.
But until then, I'm just gonna hang out, and I can't get to any of those rebels either, so I'm not even gonna bother. Yeah. You've got that handled. So
the Huns are just in a raiding stance for their most forward army. So
I'm gonna check how we're doing with the Saxons. We are of similar strength to the Saxons. They like us. Friendly, yeah. Deteriorating slightly, probably because we went into their area. So the Eastern Roman Empire is still a lot more powerful than us. The Burgundians are close in power to me. The Huns are definitely more powerful than us. So they must have more armies. And the Western Roman Empire is definitely more powerful than just me. So not the two of us. That's good to know kind of where we stand. We're making pretty stinking good progress. But yeah, I'm going to bank money for a few turns. I'm not really going to buy any troops or anything. I'm just going to be... Actually, I will recruit a few. Let me see. I can always use more skirmishers.
Some of you guys pointed out that the stream overlay was a little bit off. So I'm now zooming the map around.
I can see that now. Cool. I don't think there's really anything else I can do unless somebody in the chat can give us any advice for next time on what to do with the family tree. Because I look at it, I have respectable power. I don't really care about anything else in this panel, but I feel like I probably should. So that's what's up. I should probably get a governor in like Belgica, shouldn't I?
Yeah, definitely, because you can then issue the edicts, which is very useful. And again, seeing we are recording this live, what's up, chat?
Hey, chat.
Hi.
Let's see. I'm gonna issue an edict. I could do religious to kind of stabilize the region. I could do growth, research rate, public order. I'm going to do resettlement.
Okay.
I feel like I can make good use of that. All right. Oh, I could still issue an edict in this province.
It's so funny. After telling that story, I think it was to Joel a few nights ago about your catapult army. Like, I just want to take it back to the field now. Just put those wheels to work. I'm looking forward to this.
I'm looking forward to fighting something.
Uh-oh.
What?
you ended your turn right as the TeamSpeak hiccup, and everything just kind of froze for a second.
No. All good over here.
Yeah. Woo! I'm at negative for my income. Matter of state, the stonemason. Subject, Gandalfer, totally not Gandalf, guys. A foreigner claiming to be a great stonemason has presented himself to you. You want to take him into your service. Okay. And office secured. Let's look at our subject first. Do I employ him? Do I turn him away? Do I have him killed? Or do I do nothing?
Hi, I'd like to work for you. Off with his head. That's the type of loyalty we don't need around here.
Alright, I'm gonna employ him. There we go. Look back at my offices here. Tribal chief. I put Getwolf as tribal chief. Yes, I believe I can. Canyon General. Okay, everyone else is basically where they should be, I believe. Hey again to chat, thanks for coming out, appreciate the kind words. If you guys are familiar with Attila Total War and do have family tree suggestions, both me and Jeremiah are kind of still a little bit lost.
It's been our family trees are just full of bastards and sass talking. That's basically
there's so much intrigue according to the banner, and so many options. I don't know. Okay. Those rebels are on my border still and building up troops, but I've got two armies here now.
Just
there
kill
we go. Them. I'm gonna auto resolve. This is gonna be a lame fight. Aggressive. Yeah, 2249 versus like 630. Replenish. Okay. New religion in Gaul. Latin Christianity. Trait gained. One of my politicians, Hug Leaker, has gained the trait flaccid. This man makes poor choices in his bed partners. That's all it is. Yes.
What on earth?
Authority -1. Chance of having children -30%.
What is this?
That's pretty great. And then our rebels are killed. That's amazing. Trait gained. Blasted. Alright, I'll do a quick save there. I should probably move Odin's Fist out of friendly territory. Saxons. I'm just gonna move them back to Lugdunum, where they can replenish. And as for the blood sickles, I'll put them in to run them. I'm gonna look real quick, Jeremiah. What other wars do we have going on right now?
I mean, the next biggest one is Hrefnus Ult, right?
Oh, we're with the Angles, to the south of my original capital back home.
Oh yeah, that's right.
That was a recent development, I think. We are allied with you. And the Western Roman Separatists, they're rebels, they don't even count. So our only current war is actually with Angulus.
Well, no, I mean, I think we're officially at war. Oh no, the Angles, no, they have, wow, they have two places way apart from each other.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
That's not bad.
I mean, okay. When it's time to wipe them out, we can link up our two territories, join the light, you know?
Going to do another quick save here because I've got to do these movements right to do this siege. Let's see. I'm going to move this army offshore. So we can reinforce. Then my navy needs to make the actual attack.
Yeah, I think so.
Or no, I can't. They have to reinforce. Oh, I can't attack in my current stance.
What's your stance? Oh, you're like forced march
double,
or something?
Double time. Ah, crap.
You're close enough. If they attack you, you can reinforce. I mean, that won't be a problem.
Apparently, I don't have the ability to reinforce while in double time.
Can you take it out of that mode?
I'm out of movement points to do that, unfortunately. Mm-hmm. It'll have to wait one more turn. They are building up more troops, but they're still injured, and I'm going to get some mercenaries, I think. I may need a slight loan if you have the funds to spare. But I think...
Do you need that this turn or another turn?
It can wait till next turn. I'll know more about exactly what I need then. So,
okay.
Character trait, and I'm good to go. Where is this guy? I'll do... level 2 morale, and then second level wolf ability. Which actually, I think this adds like morale and stuff, so. Even I think as a Viking faction, all of my men are the beard men. Just like by default.
That's why he's so slow to build up money. He's got to wait for the worthy to show up and join ranks.
Beards only. Beards only.
All right. SAO Life has a game suggestion. People watching this later on YouTube, let us know if you hate the idea of live streams creeping into your precious Total War episodes.
I figure we'll get some good suggestions along the way in real time. And it'll fill some of the downtime as we wait for the AI to finish all their moves.
Yeah, if anyone has a good productive suggestion for, especially family tree stuff, when it comes to like fighting on the field and stuff, Dave and I are pretty good. We got that.
Catapults.
Yeah, basically. I can't wait till we're facing up some real armies, and I want a second catapult army.
Dude, forget armies. I want to knock down more cities. Like that whole wall just crumbled the last attack. That was amazing.
All right, the Langobards are gone. I'm gonna have a rebellion in one of the new territories because people are exposed. The Eastern Roman Empire and the Arons are fighting each other. Don't know, don't care. Oh man, I don't know, why am I making so much money right now?
Hey buddy.
It's me, your cousin.
Would you like to do a small family loan?
I've done enough loans, I know how that goes.
Or a large family loan. Unseasonal conditions. Bad winter. Boo.
Alright, I'm up to neutral. People don't hate me here. Alright. I'll take that for now.
Make a left turn here, Jeremiah. The army that took your former capital has left. They're at sea now. And I just realized I'm not at war with the Separatists yet that took your capital. So I can declare war and then take the city from behind them.
Nice. As long as... that's interesting. Why would they just leave? Either they're dumb... Well, I guess if you're not at war with them, maybe they don't care.
For you? That would be amazing.
Let them. I don't know. Well, actually, back home, I don't really have a whole lot that can defend against that. I might need to recruit a few units. I don't really have... Ready for battle! I'm going to station my guys in London. What can I recruit in London? Oh, I can recruit a lot more in London. I can recruit catapults.
I mean, that's all that really matters in this time period is the catapults.
I'm going to very slowly start building up a... building a little up here. Okay. I don't think there's anything else I can do. I'm going to look at my faction power. Nothing I can really do still. In Europe, I am going to change the edict to Germanic paganism. Because apparently I already have a bit of that going on. So I'm just going to emphasize that in that area, which should make people happier. That's my hope.
Yeah. Dude, every time you end your turn, my game just, like, hangs for 10 seconds. It is terrifying.
Alright, so you can try to take Hereafter Assault?
Yeah. Real quick, though, I have Political Obstruction. When one is climbing the greasy pole, there is but one rule. Hunter be hunted. That is an awful description. They've blocked my candidate. I can do Political Favors, Decree, or Forget It. I'm gonna do Political Favors. He'll lose some influence in his new position as elder, but I won't lose any face. That's the important part. Whoa, drunk on watch. Military setback. 1 in 10 men killed for a petty crime. The unit is close to mutiny. There's a lot of political stuff going on in my realm. Cool. Yeah, I think I'm going to immediately make my save here and besiege your former capital. I think it's time.
Sounds good.
I think I have enough money to do like one or two mercenaries, and that's enough for now. That's plenty.
I mean, you should be able to take the capital, and it won't really matter.
Yeah, and actually, I cannot. It looks like recruit in the ocean. So okay,
what?
Where are those geet separatists? An official declaration of war. This is good stuff. I like this.
I mean, don't make it into thing. I you know, I'm just so brokenhearted about this. Just kill him and get him out of my land.
But which army do I use? Now, Jeremiah, would you like the naval forces to do like the flanking maneuver from behind?
I would like you to kill everybody who lives in that town right now.
We do have a fight ahead of us, so...
Okay, alright, I'm down.
Do it.
How big of a fight?
Ooh. It says even odds, but looking at the numbers, I have better troops and more of them. It's just, they have a lot of, like, little armies reinforcing, so...
Well, we'll use our typical advantage, which is there are two of us. If you want to give me, some horses or something, I can go be harassing...
Well, I'm thinking one of us is going to want to do just naval, so...
You. I hate naval. Do you hate naval?
No, I don't mind. It's just that the naval army is smaller and also is reinforcing, so... I like handing you the reins to my primary army does make me pause. I don't know.
Well, this is a nice long load.
And Debbie's in chat swinging that ban hammer.
Talk okay. Shit, get shot.
Oh. All right.
All right, so what do you want me to have here?
I'm looking and...
Is your...
Army's actually out to sea. So here, take all my cavalry.
Wait, so is your navy... This is your army right here. Your navy's going to reinforce, aren't they?
Yeah, so this is my army, but on boats, yeah, okay. Which is a little confusing, but looking for a good landing zone.
I'd say the quickest place you can set them down.
I mean, yeah, I'm thinking take the hill, Jeremiah.
You want me to take the hill?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll start the landing because I don't know if I can give you all my troops before I get more. I don't have nothing left, but you already have the cavalry, right?
Yeah.
Is that where you want them?
All right, well, hold on. You want me to take the hill? Yes. There is a wall.
No wall. If you look, I'm gonna set you up for a landing like this, and then right up into the center.
Oh, I mean for the cavalry though, there's a wall on that side.
Yeah, maybe redeploy those elsewhere.
I'm not honestly sure where. I can redeploy them on this side, it'll be a bit of a run. But yeah, I'm good. I understand what you're saying for the others.
Okay,
yeah.
Cool.
Yep, I'm good with that. I'm gonna hide the cavalry in the woods a little bit.
Does it feel weird, Jeremiah, attacking your own capital?
No, I'm excited. I'm surprisingly okay with this.
You ready for this?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Alright, I'll start all the landings for you, and then you can just take over.
Can you gift them to me? Yeah, you can gift them after the fact.
I'll just go ahead and give them a move order.
So let's see what they've got now that the battle has started. I don't know where their whole army is. I'm not seeing a lot of people here.
It's a little bit spread out. It looks like they have catapults. Okay, I have the naval forces. Incoming gift. There you go. Everyone right. Has attack and move orders, interceptions, and a good mix, so...
Okay. We don't stand a chance. There's a couple little, boats here. I'm gonna deploy these slingers towards them.
I'm going to engage some of their forces that were out to sea. Back here.
Boarders on one of our ships. Repel them.
There we go. Goodbye, artillery ship. You got your one shot.
All right, I'm
ready and able.
Chucking stuff at them.
I'm gonna try to get my boat archers where they can shoot flaming arrows into the land armies. That seems appropriate, right?
Yeah. All right, so let me see. Okay, I see the rest of your army landing over there. Cool, cool, cool. Okay, they've got a couple people. They're going to harass you when you land. So I'm going to run the cavalry straight into their archers.
Nice. Perfect.
And I think their king or their general is with that group. Let's go for an early kill on him.
Oh, yeah, you're right. He is. There he is. He's in this unit of Nordic Marauders. That's a pretty intense looking unit, so be careful. But
they're mustering people on the shore. I think I'm going to be slogging it out on the shore here a little bit.
Yep, I'm heading towards my landing zones here.
Unfortunately, I'm just going to have to rush straight in and crush with their spears. There's nothing else I can really do.
Yeah, if you can try to get to that tower before they get totally to shore, I'm just going to attempt to make a full landing like behind their walls. Why is that pinned?
Why are the horses so slow? Okay, here we go. Oh, shoot, they're trying to get back inside. Dang it. Yeah, they're going to get back inside. Okay.
But that's where I'm landing, so...
Wait, I can run up behind them. Yeah, I'm going to hit the gatehouse from the other side.
Perfect.
All right, let me go check on the landing. Well, this fight out in the water is taking a lot longer than I thought it was going to.
Yeah, it tends to get bogged down out there. The pathfinding for the landings is wonky at best.
I don't know if the horses are smart enough to get around this.
All my boats are just like colliding back and forth. Come on, guys, land.
Yeah, they're not moving. I don't know if I can make the horses do what I want them to do. I've got to pull the horses back.
Okay.
Yeah, they're not getting through.
If I can break into their walls from behind, I can just let the horses in, so... Okay, intercepting their king. Can I land this back here? Okay, there's two spots back here I can land.
Alright, but then... This fight is still going out in the water.
One of our ships can no longer fire!
This is a surprisingly hard to attack place here.
Yeah, it's the awkward landing zones that don't help.
I don't think there's anywhere I can really get through with these archers.
Yeah.
This is actually turning out to be a more complicated battle than I thought it was going to be.
Yeah, they were spread out, but we had to end up spread out too. The men have thrown down their weapons and are fleeing. Alright, everybody just get in there at that general. Get in there. If I can swarm their general, maybe I can get him down quickly. Okay, they're landed now. You guys just land outside.
Alright, I'm taking down one of their watchtowers.
One of my boats is stuck on their boat, I think. Oh, once the boats land, you can actually then land more.
Alright, let's see.
Wow, their general is a tough nut to crack. On Earth.
Alright, I finally have some troops moving up now.
Okay. Let's go! If I can kill their general, I think I'm just gonna pull back towards you. Leave the walls alone, go for that quick grab at the hilltop. What do you think?
Is there any way you can let me in with the horses?
No, because they have three units on the walls. There's just no way.
Okay.
Yeah, I've got archers coming up, but they're almost out of ammo. They're probably going to rout. Their general is just wrecking me over here.
I'm going for the hill.
Okay. I think my other two units, Jeremiah, I'm not going to try to get after their general because he's throwing back everything. I'm going to just join you with my last two units. We got to get up that hill or it's all over. I can't... My troops just aren't congregated enough to actually put up a good fight.
Down their weapons and are fleeing.
Just capture anything you run past if you're able.
Yeah, this is not going well at all.
We hunger for blood and battle. Ready for battle.
A bloody battle down here on the shores.
We hunger for blood
and they're broken. They broke another unit there. I'll capture as I go by, but definitely keep moving to join your main force.
They're not done yet.
I'm pushing a couple spearmen. All right, I'm breaking them. All right, we're about to have a big one coming up here.
Yeah, I see him. And one of my only units of swords is stuck offshore. That sucks.
I'm running some spears up the hill if I can. They're being harassed. I'm going to try to just hit their main force and hold it in the middle while I run guys up the hill.
Warriors, move out! Warlord!
Wait, is that my king? Uh-oh. I think I may have made a big mistake here.
What was your mistake?
I think my king is deployed in the middle of all this.
I mean,
my faction king. I did that again. Breaking the engagement. I did not mean to have my king on the front lines again.
Not great for the morale, that one. We can take these guys. I'm getting into a better position here.
Damn you! We'll kill them all! Deadly missiles ready! Back! Live to fight another day!
Alright, I'm getting skirmishers up on the hill.
Okay. We got swordsmen coming in from the right side here. I'm moving my archers back because they're out of ammo. And they're going to be awful in melee. I mean that my king was on a naval fleet, which I did not realize at all. Must rescue king. I'm gonna sacrifice these swordsmen. Text my king.
Alright, I'm getting guys into the square. Alright, I'm gonna set up a defensive thing on the hill and make them come at us.
Yeah, I'm gonna pull my king back to that line. Get in there, archers. We got help now.
The victory point is about to fall to your men.
Okay, victory point, chieftain house. That is the one that wins us the battle. So, can you spare a second unit just to speed that process up?
I've got two more running up the hill right now. They're just slow.
You might want to pull that one spearman back to hold the line while the other two capture the one in the lower part of the hill.
I'm not worried about the line. They don't have anything serious up here. I got it.
Okay.
And I'm getting more organized here.
That's true. It's not bad.
Yeah, we're gonna get them.
Look at my king though. So tired running up. With that one unit of swordsmen holding back their king.
I just wish I could get... If I could get the horses in somehow. But, you know, it'd be a bad city if you could just run around the wall, so...
Yeah, I'm zooming in on these guys. They're holding the line so that the king can get away.
We hunger for blood and battle! Forward!
And they are broken, but the king is pretty far away. I'm going to hit that sword unit in the back. Jeremiah, can you help? I guess that would break the line, wouldn't it? My king couldn't get up there fast enough. I can't stay here long. See if I can hit him in the back and break him quick.
The capture's going pretty fast now.
Okay.
Can you run to my lines, or will your guys not move?
I'm going to try to. I wanted to hit him in the back to try to break their morale, but they're not breaking fast enough, so... No, they broke. Okay. Then I'll use my archers as the next shield to get my king further back. I may need some assist. No, they broke off. Okay.
I can't get to you right now. I've got one thing of spears I could get to you with. Oh, they got a big thing running at you. Hold on. I got some spears I can run into them.
That's all swords. Right. I got to hit him head on.
Their guys are coming at us now. They're getting a little more organized.
And there's more coming, but if we can get that capture point, we can end it quickly.
All right, I ran my spears in the back of their swordsmen. That should hurt them a little bit. And I've got missile superiority, and I've got the hill. I don't think we're going to lose the path.
The enemy's victory point is ours now.
All right, sweet. They're counting down. 143 seconds.
Okay, pull them back. Full speed. Because their swordsmen are coming up, too.
Battle ready and eager.
Oh, this is going to be a lot closer than I wanted it to be.
Ooh, gosh. All right, they're hitting us now.
My Kingsguard is just trying to get up here.
Shoot, oh crap. Two of my spears just broke all at the same time.
I'm putting my Kingsguard in the fight.
My guys are running down the hill as fast as possible.
It's all or nothing. Still pissed about these swordsmen off the shore. I needed you guys. Oh, the boat's gone now. Land, you fools. Land up here. Even better. Land down here. The game had to like delete the other team's boat so I could land.
Mm.
I could get loose.
Men have thrown down their weapons and are fleeing.
Yeah, some of our guys are starting to break here.
King's guard's breaking.
Oh shoot.
He's still alive, but
one of their big towers is coming for us now.
Big towers?
One of their like What do you want to call them? The sentry towers that shoot the fire arrows? They can reach my guys on the hill.
Oh, I didn't see that.
It's okay. 67 seconds.
I do have swordsmen coming. They're going to land really close, but it probably will be over by then.
I'm just smashing everyone straight down the hill.
I'm hoping my King Guard can get out of that, but... Oh, he's controllable again. Get back, you fool! You're behind enemy lines!
Where is your king?
In the middle of everything at the bottom of the hill. Yeah, he's broken again, but my king is still alive. If he can just get out of there.
They're broken. I'm running for their lives.
Missile. 18 seconds, come on, hold it. Hold
their king's hill. Almost dead. Oh, no, they still got a few people left.
It will be ours in short order.
That king, though, held off like 8 of my units by himself. Well, he had one unit come up and assist near the end, but... King be OP.
Victory is upon us.
And victory calls.
Ending the battle right now.
You're still going to have to chase him down and finish him off.
But I'll have the city. I can call on mercenaries now and reinforcements. Like, whew. Close. Very close. All right. That not, I was going to say. Most of their armies are dead. One of the reinforcing armies did survive, but most of them are in fact dead. Loot and occupy gets me 3,400. Occupying gets me not much.
I mean, you could probably use the 3,400.
I'm gonna be here for a while. I'll just go ahead and loot and occupy. Yeah. Ooh, my fleet is banged up. I do have 7,100 now. That's nice.
That's more than me.
I'm bad at distance. Someone in the last episode was pointing out that we were like missing like a really key part of our tech tree that meant we had like starting units still. I'm really trying to remember what that was.
I mean, I've got all my starter military tech tree stuff.
military jetties, chieftain's house, village, Nordic brigade, Nordic spearmen, Nordic pikemen. We're here at Alibu. That fields, convert that to pastures. Okay. Looking through a couple options here. I'm not really seeing anything that jumps out at me as like, this is a military upgrade that you need, but I will go down here to, what's bigger, Alblana or Tuesis, and convert something. Actually, all my cities there are just fine. There were a couple of cities I needed to convert to be like Nordic types of cities. Looking for those. Ah, Lugdunum is one of them. I do need another 10,000 for that, so I will hold off for now and just check out my tech tree. Involuntary levy, that's my next upgrade. Alibu is good. I will recruit a few more troops in your capital. Is that my king? Hugleaker is his name.
Hugleaker?
Hugleaker is what it looks like.
Your king's got a dumb name, man.
I'm sorry. I don't know what to tell you. I mean, you're not wrong. No, my king is Gutthulf.
That's better.
And he is in Hrefsnaholt. Oh, he is in the navy. He's on the navy of all places. So my admiral became my king at some point. Weird. And can't raise taxes anymore without making people angry, so, oh, great. Assign skills. Gutthulf. Give you some more cunning. Unassigned tradition. The blackened sails.
Ready for battle.
Integrity plus one. Full strength plus five. That should do it. Man, so many things to go through. Hello again to chat. Thank you guys for stopping by. My Imperium level is now intimidating. Your power is both feared and coveted. Yes, it is.
Oh, are you just now intimidating?
Oh.
I've been intimidating for a while.
Is it because you're so tall?
It is a little bit awkward. I think we have to squeeze by a lot of our friendly countries and then start wrecking face on ones we don't care about. What are the Geat Separatists up to?
They're offshore, right? In that army, they're begging for mercy. They want a peace agreement. Denied.
Are you sure you don't want to just... Okay.
So no, because they're going to attack at some point. I want to finish them off with my navy once it's repaired.
I wonder if you wanted to wait and then finish them off when you're in a position of a little more power.
Yeah. Shadow Fox, I'm streaming so late because I haven't been able to for months due to internet issues, and we just finished up the podcast at about 10:15. I already had the lights turned on, figured, hey, let's try an actual game stream after the podcast. And it's working, it appears.
I gotta go kill some rebels real quick.
Oh, I see you moving.
They're gonna run, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah, I guarantee it.
Where'd they go? Dang it. I can still get them.
Zanzibar's in the chat. He was in a Battlefront game with me earlier. Talking about that in the podcast tonight. The PC version looks so good. Like 1440p makes a difference. I had 120% scaling on too. 60 FPS locked, Jeremiah. It was beautiful.
That does sound pretty good.
I mean, the Frostbite engine is just...
Alright, what do I got going on? A subject. The stolen sword. Swords are possessions of pride, but such precious things can also cause discontent. Your brother's boy claims another has stolen his sword. The accused denies it. I will arbitrate. That seems like the most peaceful way to handle that. We'll see. Alright, everybody else is kind of holding here. Do I want to spend any money? Or do I just want to... I feel like I should be spending some money on improvements to a couple different places. I need to do all those back home first, though, because back home is best. Back home is best home. That's going to be a lot of money. But then I'll have one area that's entirely built in 9 turns, so that's probably the right move. Yeah, other than that, I'm just going to kind of hold it down, put out fires. So this is interesting. The Western Roman Separatists, let me see how they feel about the Huns, because there's a lot of them together right now. Western Roman Separatists, let me see. They are not fighting the Huns. They're not trading with the Huns. They're not allied with the Huns. They're nothing with the Huns. They're just there. Okay.
Awkwardly there.
Yeah, I don't really know what to do about that. Okay. Let's see. The Angles. Okay, yeah, that's right. They don't like us. Saxons. Let me see if I can improve anything with the Saxons since they're not
I have little game. They're not thrilled right now. The day on you. What you say had better please my ears.
Nothing I can really do with them. That sucks. I feel like we may have to either make peace with the Saxons or roll them pretty hard.
I mean, we're not at war with the Saxons, right?
We're not, but their attitude towards us is deteriorating at a pretty steady rate because we're in their area attacking other people.
Yeah, and I was actually in their country too briefly, which was...
I think we just need to be... We need to be pretty strong, and I think we just need to be ready to move on anybody at any time.
Yeah.
Unfortunately. Yeah. I think that's what's going to come down to, so... Alright, I'm not going to spend any more money. Oh, I can assign a skill. How wonderful.
The Engels to the south have a navy of 3 tiny ships called the Doom from the Deep.
I'm like, the Doom really? In the Deep?
Yeah, from the Deep, yeah. Mm. The Stonemason. The man bends the knee before you and then suddenly rushes at you with a blade in hand. One of your most trusted advisors gets between you and the assassin, giving his life for yours. Well, let's see what happens the next time a fancy stonemason comes for a job. Some poor person's gonna show up for an application and get their head cut off. My lord, no!
My lord, yes.
The Separatists do have an army of 12 still, which is... Yeah, mildly concerning. Can I run these guys down on the shore, though? Yeah, they're gonna run. Of course you are. Yeah, I'm going to auto-resolve that. Aggressive. That's bloody. Wheat. Replenish.
And then will your next conquest be Angulus, do you think?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, now keep in mind, that's going to make you more at odds with the Saxons.
Yeah. Mm. But
But the Saxons, they're also near the Angles over, like, over in France, or what will become France. So we're going to be in their territory regardless of when we attack the Angles.
Yeah, and I'm looking, the Angles actually have no armies left in that northern province whatsoever. It's abandoned.
It's just the town?
Just the empty town.
Oh, that's
the garrison.
Crazy. Yeah.
So
I feel
I guess
the Saxons might be the next to go.
I'm gonna build up my navy ever so slightly, but keep saving up for that 10,000 to be able to convert some of those towns to the south.
What's the 10,000 for?
One of my towns in the south that's pretty advanced needs to be converted to a Viking style town.
Oh, gotcha. Yeah.
I feel like I can get rid of one of these guys. No, because that army is going to be moving to the south. Chat and Jeremiah, I guess, come up with a good name for the Jotun Slayers in the north. I want to rename that army to something cool.
Cooler than the Jotun Slayers.
That's probably some reference that I'm not getting, but
yeah.
I'm not a fan. Unassigned tradition.
Oh, you got some upgrades you can do too on your guys.
Do I?
Yeah. You had some on your navy earlier too, I believe.
Oh, that's right. I actually have to go in and manually
do
the upgrades.
Oh, you also have them on the Blood Sickles. You have a ton of upgrades. And Odin's Fist. Yeah, you have a lot of upgrades to do.
Yeah, I think I've forgotten about that for a while.
Name the Jotun Slayers. Winter's here, bitch. It's not a great idea.
The Knights of the North does have a good ring to it. Just Winter is a little simple. I think Justin's in a dark mood tonight because he suggested the darkness. Jack, I started uploading videos to YouTube in 2008, just some Worldling Conflict, like custom maps I was working on. I uploaded some Bad Company 2 videos in 2010, just for me and Edgar, a few friends of mine. And then in 2011, as Battlefield 3 was approaching, and me and Jeremiah decided we were going to play that game together, I started uploading some stuff for like the Battlefield 3 beta, stuff like that, and some of it kind of exploded, and I was like, I'm making these videos for us anyway, you know, might as well keep uploading them, and it kind of took off from there. Still just a hobby, but I still enjoy it, so I guess that's something to be said after quite a few years. The Wheels of Hellfire. I just love that. Blood Sickles. Odin's Fist. I do like Odin's Fist. That'll probably...
You could do Broden's Fist.
That is awful. I'm alt F4ing right now.
I didn't say it was good. I just said you could do it. And I feel like I need to get these catapults back on the road. Justin suggests the Darkness of the North.
I don't think there's really, like, traditional knights yet in this time period, because it's, what is it? Yeah, it's 413 AD. It's a little early for, like, traditional knights, as we would consider the word.
Let me float an idea to you while you're thinking of names.
Okay.
So the Saxons, you know, their opinion of us is deteriorating. We
right.
will need to do something. Tlerfordom is a very strong town, but I have a catapult army. Avaricum is near you. What if each of us got up to 3 full stacks in each of our armies in France, and then you go for Avaricum and Vienna, and I go for Tlerfordom, and we try to wipe him out in one fell swoop, and we could connect our kingdoms a little bit more.
Okay, I'm following.
I mean, this is like the big move we can start preparing for, because the situation is deteriorating. Sooner or later, they're going to want to attack us. We can do it on our terms, on their turf, with our catapults.
Yeah.
And if we attack them both at the same time, we know they have armies, but they'll have to split their forces, and hopefully we can hit them hard enough that they won't be really able to do anything about it.
Okay, do me a favor. Draw on the map the area that you would attack, because some of those provinces are in the fog of war for me.
Okay, where's my drawing? Here we go. I would attack this coming from here.
Okay.
While you attack this coming from where you are. And they do have, and they've got Aqua Sextae farther south. I think it's the same area. I don't know what else they have. I only see those four towns. And the biggest one by far is Tullerfordum. That is a massive town. So that's the perfect place to take those catapults, because that would be, I mean, that would be a nasty fight.
And in the north, Jeremiah, after I wrap up the Separatists and Angulus, I can just have my army parked there ready to reinforce your two
armies. Exactly. That's what I'm thinking. Yes. So this is like, this is long-term planning stuff here. This is like 10 turns from now, possibly. But if we start raising the armies now and getting them to where we can start, we can move them quick, as long as the Huns don't come north. If the Huns come north, everything goes on hold until we defeat them. But honestly, they don't look like they want to. They showed up and they've just been hanging around. So maybe we leave to go attack the, you know, we go attack the Saxons and they decide it's time to kill
roll
us.
Over but, us. Yeah.
Yeah. But I feel like that is a good long-term plan, because at that point, we will have a good section of the north of France. We'll have connected our starting areas with France, more or less.
Yes, yeah.
We'll get rid of the fog of war, and then Britain is about as safe as it could possibly be.
And, you know, historically, it kind of makes sense. Like, we'd be basically taking all of the coastal plains up until the inner mountains. Like,
exactly, and then, like, place people we're friends with, the Franks. Let's see. And the Burgundians who are up there, we can make them tributary states. They can stay our friends, whatever. But, like, they just have to fall in line quick, or at that point, everybody can be rolled.
I like this plan a lot. I will make a save, and I apologize, because I'm just now realizing that the reason that I can still go to the diplomacy screen is because it's still my turn.
Yes. Yes, very much so.
I was waiting on you. yeah, let's do it. I like it.
Now, of course, being Total War, who knows what's going to come up in the meantime, but I feel like we're big enough that people can't just mess with us anymore. And all I'm doing is saving up money and fixing all my towns to dramatically increase my revenue stream. That's my whole primary purpose.
Yeah, yeah, I like this plan. And I feel like Britain is pretty happy compared to how they were like 10, 15 turns ago. We like both had some rebellions back on our new territories that were concerning, for sure.
And that, I feel like, could really start the steamroll. I think I might only have one army of pure regular troops, and the other two armies will be mixed heavy catapult and regular troops.
Yeah.
Because what I'm going for with the catapults is just a level of force that the game's AI will not be thinking about. Like, they will not be compensating for, like, 30 catapults.
Yeah. At least we hope not, right?
Yeah.
Warriors all!
People are withholding taxes. The Huns and the Vandals are at war. A lot of stuff going on. Alright, first let's deal with... some citizens have been withholding payment of your just taxes.
This is...
I will talk them down, because I am merciful-ish.
I think the winning army name here is going to be the Bearded Barbarians.
Well, that's pretty good.
I like that.
All right, nothing else I can really do. I just need to roll turns and get money.
Yeah.
Roll turns, get paid. So I'm keeping my agent down south, keeping an eye on what the Huns are doing. The Huns are just raiding, and the Western Roman Separatists have taken all those towns, and the Huns have gone farther south from there.
Perfect.
So I don't really know what all that means. But they're not in our immediate area right now, except for the one horde, which could be doing anything. What would you have? So
now that's the Golden Army. Is that the army? I think.
I don't know.
I think it might be.
I'm gonna go send my agent down over here, and I'm just gonna peek around a little bit more. The Western Roman rebels. The Western Roman Separatists and the Western Roman Rebels are two independent factions. Go figure. That is complicated. There are some politics going on here.
So they had a rebellion in their territory. Splitting is basically what that means.
it looks like it would take me at least two turns to get a catapult army to Telerfordom. So that's good to know. Yep, I'm just going to roll turns for a while.
Okay. I'm going to have to do the same, it looks like. I'm so close to that 10,000, I feel like I'm just going to sit until I get it. It's going to be a long time before I have that kind of cash on hand to do that upgrade.
And which one are you upgrading again?
It is going to be... I think it was Lugdunum.
Also, upgrade your troops this time.
That costs money though, right?
Does it? Retraining them?
Yeah. It's going to cost 94. So yeah, I've definitely like forgotten to do that. I think many, many times. Ready for orders. Gosh. I'm so close. Okay. I'm going to keep hoarding that money. I'm going to do one turn of extreme taxes.
Good luck. Once you get that tax money, hard to turn it down. Avaricium and Vienna are both fairly low in their rating, so they might be pretty easy to take.
Okay.
I'm just looking.
I won't go crazy extreme, but the few of the regions back in Britain are not too happy already. I don't want to push the taxes, but one turn, it may be like a 200 coin loan from my good buddy Jeremiah, and I can get one of these big upgrades out of the way.
All right.
I tried to move the bearded barbarians to the south, and they like ran around the wrong part, so they just wasted all their movement points.
Total War. Never change. Please change.
I think my number one complaint, like outside of like performance and, you know, crashes, which always suck, is just the pathfinding is never good.
I mean, it wasn't good in Age of Empires.
I had one episode of Empire, I think, in the last couple months. I think it was the Civil War series, I'm pretty sure, where like I just raged at the pathfinding for like an entire battle. I think by the end I had four different units like stuck on fences and things that couldn't retreat off the map. I couldn't delete them, I couldn't move them, I couldn't have them attack. They were just like running in place, so they were taking up space. I couldn't call in more troops to reinforce. They were just taking up space and could do nothing. So mad.
Alright, okay, the Saxons have two full stack armies in my area. They're not at war with me. They look like they're gonna attack the Western Roman rebels. They're right near Visantio.
Yeah, what are those guys doing?
I don't know. I'm gonna go ahead and garrison my guys up. And let's just see how that plays out. That's kind of interesting. I feel like I need to be doing more loyalty securing.
Yeah, Justin, H1Z1 is where it's at, man. Think, guys, I could be streaming a fascinating Daisy experimental server browser screen. So I hit enter for 3 hours over and over again.
All right, yeah, I'm gonna kind of just leave them alone for a while. I'm getting to the point where, like, I'm getting fewer and fewer of those red triangles, and more you can actually make upgrades now. Although I've got too many that, like, I need to spend $5,000 turning Eberacum into a city finally.
Exactly, and $10,000 is my highest one of those, which is why it looks like next turn I can finally get it out of the way, and I think that'll snowball from there.
Yeah, I want to get the income up to where, like you said, you start that Total War snowball, and then each turn you're just dropping coin on whatever you want.
Yeah, for sure. It's funny, usually in Total War games, by the time you've captured this many territories, like the steamroll has already started, you know. Attila's a different animal for sure. You know, it's, wouldn't you agree, Jeremiah? Like it's like
it's a lot harder.
Like secure and
yeah, it's a lot harder to do pretty much anything.
Jack, I was not in the armed forces. The closest thing I got to the armed forces was scouts. A friend of mine used to always joke that, you know, if the Russians invade, it's the U.S. military, the National Guard, the police, and then the Boy Scouts of America holding the line.
Nah.
I have my patriotism merit badge. All right. My game froze, so it must mean you've ended your turn. Yep.
I have.
Here we go. While walking in the wilderness, a young traveler claims to have seen a vision. Good omen for 3 turns.
Okay.
Which is good. No, that's very good. Public order +2 for free for all my territories.
Oh, okay. News spread fast.
Ooh, Jeremiah, that means I can do another turn of this tax level for free, basically.
Yep,
you see where this is going?
Yeah, I see exactly where that's going. You're like, you better be happy. I've got so many troops, I'll just beat you down.
The tyranny has begun. Okay. I'm converting to a burg.
Let's continue and upgrade a few troops. Do a few every turn if you can spare it.
Yeah, I can only do like... Oh, no. I have 170. I can do literally no upgrades. Just enough for the city.
Let's continue scheming a little bit. The Saxons have at least 2 basically full stack armies of pretty standard units like ours. They appear to be mostly foot soldiers, something to keep in mind. So we have at least that to compete with.
Yeah. Jeremiah, look at your former capital back home real quick, because I don't like what the Rugians are doing, whatever that might be off my coast right now.
Hmm.
See that?
They're friendly, aren't they? But that's a lot of them. That is a lot of them.
And they're injured too, so they come from a fight. Oh, we have a non-aggression pact. I mean, that worked for Stalin, right?
Well, let's not assume, but in the same way, you're also screwed if they suddenly decide... No, you're not screwed, actually. You've got a city, you've got a couple armies. I mean, it's bad, yeah. But I also, it doesn't look like they have that much territory. So if they do that, it'll be inconvenient for us, but they're going to die. By the way, did you change your stream name to Total War?
I did.
Okay. It just didn't update on my screen.
Yeah, I think if you had the tab open, it didn't change. Jack, I actually have played Mount & Blade Warband, and I actually had no idea what I was doing, but I liked it. Like, it was cool. I was just very, very lost.
All right, so the Saxons, look like they're splitting up and sending one army to each of the 2 areas we'd be attacking.
They heard us talking. You don't understand, Juan. The news of the good omen just spread across the whole kingdom because the king made sure that everyone heard. Guys, this random kid had a good omen, so love your country more for a while. I don't know how that works. I just like the results. Okay.
All right. I'm in famine again. All right. I got
to... Oh, man. Famine again.
Lusians and the Alans have negotiated peace.
The Harbingers are going after your separatists, Jeremiah, off the coast. Gonna save us some time.
Oh, really? All right.
Yeah.
That's nice of them.
Carry on.
I think the Saxons, the Frostbearers, it looks like they're just trying to get home. It doesn't look like anything is amiss. The Huns have moved very slightly farther north. They're getting close to Lugdunum there. I don't know if you saw.
Ooh. Yeah, I see that.
Yeah.
Their army's a bit banged up, and is that...
I'm going to check out the Saxons. Nothing else. I'm going to start heading to Telerfordum. with one of my agents, check them out. Their army's a little banged up. It hasn't gotten any better either, so that's good to know.
I think you're right. I think with that big city upgrade aside, I need to work on upgrading my troops. Oh, yeah. Sorry, John. I just went with the first pronunciation that I could think of, which is usually the wrong one.
How dare you, Dave?
Plus, it was Cinco de Mayo. Get those Spanish pronunciations in the brain. I didn't have any Mexican food on Cinco de Mayo, but I think it's like the first day in a while I haven't, so that counts, I guess.
All right, so here we just need to know where we're at with the Saxons. We're a little bit stronger than them, or I'm a little bit stronger than them right now. They like our cultural affinity, our treaties with them, religious affinity, blah, blah, blah. They do not like that we're so strong. That's what they don't like. They don't like that I have treaties with the Jutes, you. They don't like the war with the Angles. They don't like the treaties with the Jutes again. Or battle support for the Jutes. They don't seem to really like you, but they mostly don't like the fact that we're so strong.
I'm looking at Avaricum, and their people are pissed. Like, negative 85 right now and negative 2 per turn. So, as we build up armies, they might split on their own.
Yeah, they might. It's just Telerfordom is still going to be... That's going to be a tough fight either way. You know, under a pretense... Well, no. I want you to have Angulus. Never mind. You say, I could... if I take Telerfordom, though, Angulus is in the same area as Telerfordom.
Is it?
It is. I thought it was in... No, okay. So, Hefen, Alabu, and Hrafnisol, they're together. So, you should definitely have all those.
Okay.
But maybe I could take... Maybe I could take a couple of my armies down and take Angulus as, like, a precursor. How would you feel about me having Angulus?
I don't mind supporting. Yeah, that's fine.
I mean, because then just so we can capture, like, one of us owns an entire one area.
I mean, I own your capital now, Jeremiah. You have a negotiating point from there.
That's true. I just think that might be the wisest course of action. Because then that lets me move troops without it being an actual hostile action.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Although, I mean, I doubt they're going to like that. I wonder if I should do that now or if I should wait. I'll wait till I can get a third army in there.
Yeah.
I'll recruit.
It's one of those nights. It's been a couple hours of streaming.
I'm talking so much. Come fight for us, lads. We'll make this one a little more balanced. I'm only going to have 7 catapults in this one.
Okay.
And it'll be, you know, more standardized troops.
That to the northeast, the Ottomans. I'm just excited because it feels like we're actually making constant forward progress. Occasional hiccups, but like...
All it takes is for the Huns to show up with 3 armies and be like, guess what?
But Jeremiah, we have 2 offshore facilities now.
Cranking out troops.
Mission issued, the glory of battle, defeat the hammers of Thor. I get plus 1,000. Ooh.
Who are the hammers of Thor?
It's your separatist army.
Oh, okay. The ones in the boats.
Yeah. I'm going to go ahead and try that, I think. Can I reach them now? Not.
Because your friends would possibly reinforce the Harbingers of Woden as... Not a bad name.
Let's see. Yeah, let's see what the odds are. I'll take a quick peek.
Never tell me the odds.
Oh, he ran away. Oh, and now he's out of reinforcement range of the other army. Fall back. Alright, well, that was a waste. I'm gonna lower my taxes before I forget and just enjoy this income for too long.
Oh geez, I didn't realize the new army I'm raising, they're already gonna be an 18 stack in a couple turns.
Nice.
Yeah, they have to be fighting at that point. That is too much money. Because then I can still leave my... I might leave... Yeah, I'll leave one of my armies in, Belgica. Belgium, I guess. And then I can take two of them towards Angulus. Which should be more than enough to take Angulus.
Yeah.
At that point, maybe I'll just take Flevum from the Franks. I think they're not very strong. They're very friendly with us, but everybody's going to start hating us sooner or later. I know that's not the smartest plan.
Yeah, let's let everyone hate us like one at a time, possibly.
And we'll just snipe them as the time comes. When their time comes. The Alamans, they're going to be a bit of a piece when it's time to deal with them, too.
Gotcha.
Just to keep in mind. So what are you doing for your turn?
I was just about to fill you in because it's been a productive turn money-wise. I have upgraded all of my armies completely.
Oh, nice.
I have 52 left in my treasury, but they're all upgraded. And I have some new ships coming next turn. My projected income is 199, so that might need some rebalancing, but...
If only you could raise taxes. Oh, wait.
I'm looking back in Britain, and they need to be happy for a few turns. They're plus 6 right now, but they were, like, negative 20.
Yeah.
So.
Okay, all right, the Saxons took their army out of my territory back to their place. Sweet.
You do have one to the north still, though.
Wait, no... Actually, never mind. They just moved to the other side of the city. Where are they going?
Feels like north, but...
North to what, though? I own everything north. You know what I'm saying? I don't really like the direction that's going.
But their biggest capital's to the north. Northeast, but...
Yeah, but they're not heading towards it. They skipped the land... The piece of land that heads towards it.
Yeah.
Yeah. The Huns have left the area. Small blessings. Oh, are you kidding me? The Western Roman rebels are...
Where are
they? Jeez. Okay, I've got a lot of crap going on right now. They're attacking Bassanio.
I see it.
Oh, they're up to 11. Ready for battle. Well, screw you, idiots.
Yeah, of course they retreat.
All right. Yeah, I don't have time to deal with that right now. Okay, I've got some guys that can be promoted to higher offices here in a bit. Let me see.
Jack, to answer your question, as far as Fallout goes, at any given time, I've got like... probably like 3 or 4 active builds going and like a few more ideas I'm playing with. So right now I think I have at least 3 or 4 like actually main builds that I am working on. Always got plenty of ideas. Ready for orders. Warriors all. Which is actually why I can't just like hand out my save game with all my builds in it, is because it's a bunch of stuff that's going to be, you know, probably months from now that I'm already working on now that don't want to share too early.
So the Rugians sailed that fleet that was attacking my separatists. They sailed it up to Flevum. I think they're all friends. Let me check out some of that situation right now. All right, the Franks are totally good with us.
Yeah,
They don't like great power, but they don't like they're pretty cool with it. They like that we have treaties with them. They like we have a religious affinity. They're good with all that. Okay, let's see. The Alamans, what is their deal? They're very friendly. It's deteriorating just a tiny bit, but they're extremely friendly, so that's not really something to worry about. The Thuringians... neutral, not big fans, but they're pretty far away. What are the Rugians' deal? The Rugians deteriorating slightly because I'm a great power. Other than that, they're pretty good overall. Okay.
Yeah, the Rugians, I think I still have that non-aggression pact with them, and they're pretty happy with me at least.
Yeah, it looks like the only thing I've really got to worry about is the Saxons are quietly becoming less and less cool.
Yeah, the Saxons for me too are really becoming unfriendly.
All right, I'm gonna save up a little more money. I've got some nice upgrades that'll be coming soon. It just takes so long.
Oh yeah, I just noticed my city upgrade that I just spent that 10,000 on. It takes 10 turns to go into effect.
Hey, the Doom from the Deep and the Dread Berserkers, both from the Angles, are cruising through our area right now, FYI. Near Britain.
Near Britain.
Yeah, I just noticed that.
That is a land army for sure. The first one is a land army. That's their king too. They might be going back home to their home territory, realizing that it's totally naked.
They might be. I hope so. I don't want them to land here. I'm not in the mood for that. But it looks like they're raising armies. I think they only have those couple things, though. Let me go check out.
Yeah, they're not a great power, given the fact that their home territory is undefended right now.
A very good one. They're more powerful than you think they are. All right. Well, I'm just going to roll more money for a while. Not much else to do.